but you know, I think some of these people here would know far more about it than about ideas that I wouldn't have thought about, or my best people wouldn't have thought about. The other point on digital, I think, is that, you know, Marshall McLuhan once said very famously that the medium is the message. And it is really the message, in the sense that, you know, you can, it's a very profound statement, you can think of it in various ways, but the key thing to know is that all digital consumption now, 86% of it is on the mobile phone. The fixed line internet, PC, that's pretty much almost, not non-existent, but very small from a mass audience point of view. What that means is that if it ain't on mobile, it might as well not be there, especially as we go forward. So whatever Rahul is saying on Times Now, outside of his primary audience on the analog broadcast channel, or whatever TK is saying on ET, or whatever Rajiv is saying in Times of India, or what he's saying on Radio Mirchi, if I don't enable it to work on a mobile screen in a way that it fits into the small size, and which brings in a totally different level of skill set. A lot of people have always thought that digital is essentially cut and paste, right? TK, I think, rightly said that the best digital platforms in this country are online representations of the print newspapers, which is true. But for a very long time, a lot of these online representations have worked on the idea that what you're basically doing is cutting and pasting what somebody else has done, and it's just, you know, take it from here and put it there. That doesn't work at all anymore, in all kinds of ways. One is because you have to fit the screen. Secondly, the nature of communication has changed completely. You know, if I put on a story online, I know within a minute if I made a mistake, because my reader tells me immediately. And I have to respond to that reader. If I don't, then I'm just gone. That reader is not coming back. And I think the big difference is that, look, you know, I worked in television a long time with Rahul, and our weekly guillotine war used to be the TRP ratings. For Rahul, it still is his weekly guillotine. But those ratings, or for print, there are surveys which come in once a year, and people all argue about the efficacy of those surveys. But they are all surveys, they're not absolute. They are a small percentage of the population that somebody surveyed, and it tells you what. And then you make statistical calculations as to whether this is what India is thinking or reading or consuming. On digital, I see my audience in absolute whole on real-time basis. I know exactly what my entire audience is reading at that point of time or what it's not reading. For most videos, for example, we find that within 3 seconds, people don't watch them in 3 seconds, and they zone out. That changes the way I would tell that story. I can't just pick up Rahul's Times Now video and put it there. Because even though it is good for that medium, I have to front load my 3 seconds with the point to hook the reader in. So it changes the way it changes how I deal with it entirely. I will have to bring a totally different storytelling skill set to it, which if I simply apply the tools of television to this, it'll be fine, but eventually I'll die.